Welcome back to Qualcomm Stadium in San Diego. 1-0 the US League Guatemala at the half. Let's go down to Carl Martino for the coach's game plan brought to you by Century 21. Carl has got Jurgen Klinsmann with him.
Thanks, Arlo. Jurgen, one of the reasons you set up this friendly was because it was going to show you what you were going to have to deal with in Gold Cup, a team that's organized, compact, 11 guys behind the ball. How do you think your team did against it in the first half?
Yeah, it came exactly the way we expected it. They bunkered in and they make it difficult. And unless you break them down over the flanks, you know, it's really difficult to score them the goal. So we created the chances one step at a time over the flanks, and then the goal came, you know, but it's a game of patience.
Now, you said that you were going to make some changes and bring some guys on in the second half. What are you looking for from a player like Stu Holden?
Well, we want that Suard now picks up the rhythm. You know, we have four very good midfielders, central midfielders here. And so we want him to show, you know, what he has right now. And, just play in a free way. You know, don't think too much. Just pick up your game again.
Thanks, Jurgen.
You're welcome.
Carlo?
Carl, thanks very much indeed. So the second half about to get underway. Those two changes. Stuart Holden and Mix Diskerud are in to the center of midfield for Carl Beckerman and Jose Torres. So we'll see how they fare. You probably know a lot more about Stuart Holden back at home watching, coming back from those serious injuries, than you do about Mix Diskerud, who is, his heritage is Norwegian. Actually scored the equalizer against Russia in a friendly in Krasnodar in November in that 2-2 draw. 22 years old. He isn't cap-tied yet. Here's Stuart Holden for the first time, wearing number 11. Diskerud with the floppy hair wearing number 8, almost getting onto the end of that ball. Cleared by Hernandez. Gomez, Hercules Gomez, with the only goal of the match so far. 42nd minute. And here he is to Castillo. Back to Gomez, edge of the penalty area. Surrounded by blue shirts. A little bit of trickery from Gomez, but outnumbered in the end. And he's penalised for a foul. So there's Mix Diskerud, place of Rosenborg, the Norwegian giant. And Stuart Holden, who told us yesterday, I feel part of the team again. I've got a leading role in this side, and that's what I like. He returned to the national fold as a substitute against Belgium. That was his first cap since October 2010 against Colombia in Philadelphia. He suffered that first injury in March of 2011, a tackle by Johnny Evans of Manchester United. That was 6 months on the sidelines. Then, after a brief comeback for Bolton, he had a knee cartilage problem and was out for 16 months. He returned in January, had a loan spell at Sheffield Wednesday in the Championship in England, the second division. And he said, Carl, yesterday, his knee feels great. That's not the problem anymore, is it?
Well, and the important part is he said that little explosion, that last bit of quickness was what he was struggling to get back, and he feels he has it now, and he just wants to play. And you heard Jurgen Klinsmann just say he wants him to just feel free and enjoy himself. And when you're thinking about a knee, you're thinking about an injury, it's very difficult to play free. So it'll be fun to see what Stuart Holden comes up with now that he has that sort of freedom and that confidence in his knee.
Said he feared the worst when we asked him what the lowest point was, and there must have been many. This time last year, his knee just kept swelling and swelling after any soccer action. He said he had an operation, he feared the worst, and when he came round, he was given the thumbs up immediately that everything was okay. The procedure had gone well, no lasting damage, and he's back. And he says he doesn't think about the knee that much. He's not constantly touching it and worrying about it. Interesting, when we asked him about Johnny Evans of Manchester United and was there any contact, he said Evans did call him, Carl, didn't he, on the Monday after the Saturday game, a conversation that lasted 15 seconds. Yeah. Here is Holden on the right foot, drives it low. Harris was scampering across his goal, yard or two wide.
One. He said it and he was a little upset about the fact that he was out for so long, but he's ready to put it all behind him and do things like this. Get on the ball and just look up. Great strike. And just play with that confidence, that joy again, and not constantly be thinking in the back of your head, when's this going to go wrong? When's my knee going to swell up? To just enjoy his soccer again.
Holden, no stranger to the Gold Cup. He played in the 2009 tournament. Scored a terrific goal against Grenada from outside the penalty area.
Well, he's an example of a player that you were mentioning before. that the Gold Cup was the difference between getting into a World Cup picture and not. That's when he really staked his claim.
Came on as a sub, didn't he, against England in the 1-1 draw in Rustenburg in the opening match in 2010. It was a tournament, Carl, if we look back on it, where the central midfield was always a problem area. It seems to be a different starter every game. Cross comes in to the penalty area. There's an effort by Hercules Gomez on the right foot, and Jerez makes the save. London Donovan was lurking there as well.
Hercules Gomez has always been a good goal scorer, but he's gotten so much better at finding little spaces. His running off the ball has improved, and that's one of the reasons that Santos, he's become such a prolific scorer. Difficult skill here as that ball comes over his shoulder to get enough power. Just does what he can to get it on frame.
Beasley forward towards Landon Donovan. Now Stuart Holden, Mix Diskerud. Gets it out from under his feet. Corona. Good challenge by Hernandez. Trujillo. And that long sprinting run in the first half that caused the United States a couple of problems. Here he is again. Castrillo. Another one of the Comunicaciones players. Given away by Trujillo to Diskerud. Castillo. Gomez realised he was in an offside position. Long towards Minor Lopez, and the flag is up for offside.
That back line has been very organised this game. Catching Minor Lopez offside several times in the first half.
Holden. Now here's Michael Parkhurst. Onyewu. What will be the biggest challenge for Oguchi Onyewu going forward from this point, Kyle?
Yeah, I think the fact that he didn't get regular games. You know, it's so impossible to try to get into the rhythm of international soccer when you're not playing week in and week out with your club. You know, so he's been behind trying to catch up for a long time and doing it with an injury. Now, if he can get anywhere near where he was before that knee injury, he can sneak in and get one of these spots. He's a huge presence back there.
Good fluid movement despite the United States. And Parkhurst with the low cross, arrest as well. They sprayed the ball from right to left, back out to the right-hand side again. With verve and confidence there, the United States. And already the two in the center of the park, Holden and Diskerud, are having an influence.
One, they're finding space wide, too. This early service, you saw it come off the left foot of DeMarcus Beasley in the first half, and now off the right foot of Michael Parkhurst. Definitely one way when you have a back four that won't push up, that's staying compact. There are two blocks of four, eight players sitting right in front of you, organized, just within an early service behind that back four. Force them to sprint and face their own goal.
Beasley in possession there, and you can see at the bottom of your screen, Jürgen Klinsmann leapt to his feet off the bench again into the technical area, hands in his pockets at the moment. Glaring out at the action. Diskerud. Towards the penalty area, on the right foot, Diskerud. A dipping effort, not quite enough though. Trying to get that ball to knuckle. Jürgen Klinsmann told us this morning, wants to see a little bit more nastiness from Mix Diskerud, and he's coming to camp with an improved attitude. Ready to stake a claim perhaps. Powerful header from Onyewu. Is Beasley, the captain of the United States. Landon Donovan in space here, left-hand side. There's a claim of a handball there on the side of the penalty area. And in the end, it's a goal kick awarded to Guatemala. And Landon Donovan could quite believe that.
Well, Landon Donovan just in front of me, DeMarcus Beasley, Jürgen Klinsmann also to my left, incredulous that... I mean, call what you want, call a handball, call a corner kick, do a couple things there. That's a lot different than a goal kick.
Yeah, the one thing it wasn't was a goal kick. Diskerud wins the header well. Holden, Beasley. If it could be a flick on here, it could get interesting, and there is. Gomez The cross comes in towards Landon Donovan. Was he pushed in the penalty area? Yes, he was. It's a penalty kick. Now, will Landon Donovan take it for goal number 50? Looks like he's demanding the ball here.
Well, as this ball's in the air, little push here on the back, and you can see right when Landon Donovan feels those two hands on his back and he extends those hands, he hits the ground, and there's no one else on this field that was going to take this penalty.
So Landon Donovan crouches. He knows the significance of this. He says, I'm a stats guy. It'll be wonderful to score number 50. He's on 49 international goals, Landon Donovan. Here he is with the right foot. He dinks it in, and it's goal number 50 in international soccer for Landon Donovan. The first American to register the half century in international soccer. It's come in his 145th cap. He's back in the side, and he's back on the score sheet, Landon Donovan.
Here's a look back at how they got to the penalty spot. Landon just off the shoulder of the center back, little push on his back, hits the ground immediately. Referee points to the spot. Now this is calm. Sends the goalkeeper the wrong way. Might want to get a little more height on that chip down the center, but ends up not mattering. And that's just a huge moment right there for two guys that have been through it all. We're teenagers and 20-year-olds going to a World Cup together, going through the residency program, the golden ball and the silver ball at the U17 World Cup. And that was the first guy to come over and congratulate him on hitting that number right there, 50. That's huge.
There we go. All three of the players ahead of him there, Stern, John, Carlos Pavon. They've all played Major League Soccer. Carlos Ruiz still playing his trade for DC United. He joins an elite group in the CONCACAF region with 50 international goals. Next in line for the USA was Eric Lamalda with 34. Clint Dempsey still active with 32. And here come the USA again. Donovan's on the back post. Castillo, Donovan again. Brian McBride scored 30 for the U.S. in his illustrious career.
Yeah, it was interesting, Arlo. In the first half, when Landon Donovan lined up at right midfield, I thought to myself, you know, Graham Zusi has done a great job, and at this point is the right midfielder in the World Cup if he keeps it up. I'm surprised to see Landon start there. Maybe on the left, maybe underneath the forward, or up top is where I think Landon Donovan fits into this team, and you're seeing what a difference it's made since he's moved into that front position where he plays most of the time with the LA Galaxy.
He's drifting out to the left-hand side at the moment, isn't he, as well? Here's Trujillo. I wonder, Carl, if you're a betting man, do you think Landon Donovan starts, injury permitting, of course, and the US haven't secured their qualification yet, but it looks pretty good. Does he start the first game of the World Cup Finals in Brazil?
Yes. Yeah, I think the experience, I mean, having it be his fourth World Cup, it's really impossible to quantify what that experience means. And a leading goal scorer and Gold Cup leading scorer all time, you have to have a guy like that at that tournament.
Contreras wins the ball back, but then gives it away again. Here's Gomez working against Hernandez. Shows a decent turn of pace. 32-year-old wins his side of throwing. Gomez not happy. The announcement of Landon Donovan's 50th goal in international soccer made to the crowd here at Qualcomm Stadium. They've been loud tonight, really enjoying themselves. Foul by Discaroon. Triple substitution about to be made here for the United States. This Wondolowski, Breck Shea. Wondolowski searching for his first international goal. Alejandro Bedoya as well. Six substitutes allowed in this friendly international. So Hercules Gomez is out, the goal scorer, well, the scorer of the first goal. Castillo out as well. Here's Bedoya, Helsingborgs in Sweden, his club. Only four appearances at the 2011 Gold Cup, including all three knockout games. Left Rangers earlier this year. He scored 8 goals in 17 appearances for Helsingborgs. Breck Shea applies his trade for Stoke City. Samala have made a substitution as well. This is when it starts to get a little bit complicated. Wilber Perez is in the game. Luis Cardona comes in too. Victor Hernandez is out. Brett Shea's in the penalty area, low driven cross! It was Landon Donovan at the near post who got a touch on it. The flag's up on the far side anyway for offside, or maybe the ball went out of play, actually. Let's take a look at this. Well, Landon Donovan's in the mood.
It starts with a terrific long ball from Stuart Holden. Takes a bounce, good first touch, and look at that move from Landon Donovan. The center back takes a look, trying to find Landon Donovan, and he's already gone. He's already darting to that near post. The timing of that run, perfect. Just can't put it on frame. But that ball from Stuart Holden is exactly what Jurgen Klinsmann has challenged him with. Can you play those balls forward? Can you show me the range that you had before the injury and the confidence to play that pass?
Gallardo to Contreras. Elias Vasquez, who now has a new partner at centre-back in Luis Cardona. Here he is for the first time. He'll have to hurry. On his heels, here's Brett Shea, moving forward with purpose, trying to curl it into the path of Chris Wondolowski or Landon Donovan. I think he's enjoying himself in the Premier League with Stoke City. Recovered from those injuries that he was suffering from. Says he feels good. He's had a calf problem, a toe injury as well. Feeling much better now, he told us yesterday. Wilber Perez, the substitute for Guatemala. Nicely back to Jonathan Lopez. And here's Carlos Castrillo. Towards Minor Lopez, headed clear by Oguchi Onyewu. Lopez turning. Was he pulled down there by Clarence Goodson? He thinks so. Wondolowski. Shea over the top looking for Landon Donovan. Vasquez has had a very good game tonight. That was well read. Stuart Holden. Manuel Lopez on the right foot. Thinks about a shot, then it's Contreras, curling, but well wide in the end.
Well, still Guatemala complaining about this play right here. Clarence Goodson wrapping up the player a little bit, and I think there was tugging going on with both players before it started. It started with Minor Lopez reaching back and grabbing him. Or actually, it looked like it was Perez reaching back and grabbing him. And Goodson pulling him down. Not enough for a penalty, I don't think.
Foul against Mix Discarude. Just caught Contreras late there. Fourth cap for Mix Discarude. Contreras. Wide of Marquez. Contreras again, just pulling the strings, dropping slightly deeper into central midfield for Guatemala. Jonathan Lopez. Well, that's a good looking ball to the back post. Ramondo was out bravely. Wilber Perez is putting him under some pressure. Perez and Minor Lopez now the front two with Contreras in the centre of the field. Free kick taken quickly after the foul by Jean Marquez. Holden. Is on Yewu. Now Goodson. Brett Shea from Stoke City in the Premier League. We had a really good chat during the week, Carl, didn't we, with Clint Dempsey of Spurs, of course. He played in the World Cup qualifiers. He told us about the 9-pound channel catfish that he caught recently in Texas. There's Shea to Beasley. He's played Premier League soccer as well and has won the corner. We'll get back to Clint Dempsey in a few moments' time. It's just fascinating picking his brains about Jürgen Klinsmann and the current setup for the US national team. He called Klinsmann very positive, very energetic, a workaholic. And he said things changed for the US after some reports of disquiet in the camp before the Costa Rica game in Denver. They became close as a group and as a unit after that. They won that game courtesy of Dempsey's goal in the snow. They haven't looked back since. Here's Beasley again with the corner kick. It comes in towards Shea. Was he shoved? Didn't get a header on target. Still there for the United States. Marcus O'Donovan. Space to manoeuvre here to the back post. It goes towards Brett Shea, but it's out of play and a goal kick to Guatemala. And it was interesting talking to Jürgen Klinsmann about that exact situation, because he doesn't feel, Carl, does he, that it was necessarily a turning point, the Costa Rica game. He said the players played with a bit of anger after the Honduras defeat that they were not very happy with at all.
Well, it definitely, I think, united them. It was a freaky game, and playing in the snow like that, and the article that came out about players not being happy, that was a big moment. If you ask some of the players, they say that was a moment where we really got organized and became one and went out and got a huge result, and have been getting huge results ever since.
Discaroo, Brett Shea with space here. What can he do with it? Into the penalty area it goes. Discaroo on the left foot. At all time in the world, still Discaroo. Desperately trying to get the ball clear here, Guatemala. It's all the United States at the moment.
Well, speaking of Clint Dempsey in the Premier League, as we look at this replay, watch this first touch from Mix Discaroo. Takes this down beautifully. And then the strike just blocked out. But Clint Dempsey's got a big season coming up. But so do you, Arlo. You're leaving us. This is the last game before you head over back across the pond where you're comfortable, where the sun doesn't come out and threaten that fair skin of yours. But we're going to miss you, man. Congratulations going over. But you're going to be back for playoffs. We're not missing you for good.
Absolutely. Here's Brett Shea. Into the penalty area he goes. He wins a corner. Yeah, the bags are packed. Back to the UK on Monday. And 6 weeks tomorrow, the start of the Premier League season for NBC Sports, August the 17th. Thoroughly looking forward to it. The United States has been extremely good to me.
Well, I think it was cruel of us to put you in San Diego before we send you back.
Yeah, that was unfair. I am officially having second thoughts. Donovan with the corner kick. The United States lead by 2-0. Holden will fancy this one. He drives it straight into the chest of Minor Lopez. Holden again with a bit of space here. Contreras. Now space on the right-hand side for Jonathan Lopez. Marquez. Clearance by Parkhurst in the end. Very calmly plays it into Discaroo. Chris Wondolowski, he'd dearly love an opening goal for the United States. This is his 12th cap. This is his first appearance since the Canada friendly in January. Brett Shea. He's looking for a bit of support. A bit of trickery from Shea, but well watched by Castrillo, and it's another corner. Fifth of the game for the United States. Jürgen Klinsmann is pondering one last change here as we approach the final 20 minutes. There's Wondolowski, played 3 matches at the 2011 Gold Cup. 27 goals in Major League Soccer last season, equaling Roy Lassiter's league record. Here it comes. Santillez from Chicago with a pass on the edge of the penalty area. The United States can start to build again. Touch from Bedoya. Jonathan Lopez. Comes from Onyewu. Carl, when the United States get to the World Cup finals, presuming that they do, the ball is sprayed out to the left-hand side. For Guatemala, it's a nice little move as well. Chance here for the visitors. Wilber Perez was on the end of it. That opportunity in the end. Well, couldn't get a shot in on Nick Raimondo's goal. Santillez with some fine work down the left-hand side. The challenge of the World Cup, Kyle, is a lot different to the Gold Cup, and if they're going to face a lot of teams that are going to pack it in, as we've discussed tonight, the Guatemala approach, perhaps the approach from Belize, they've got to make set pieces count, do you think, a little bit more?
Well, absolutely, especially when you've got some tall guys in there. You've got Aguchi.
Donovan here slides it into the penalty area. Here's an opportunity, and it's goal number three, and it's a big one. Chris Wondolowski has his first international goal. Oh, a huge sigh of relief for Wondolowski, who must have feared that his last chance had gone. It's his 12th cap, and he's off the mark for the national team.
Can't let Landon Donovan pick this ball up and get turned. Watch how assertive he is. Cuts inside, and this is such a terrific attempt right there to play that ball through. It gets toe-poked away. It falls to Chris Wondolowski, but watch Landon Donovan get turned. Looks up, sees where his options are, gets by a player, and this is such a delicate little pass he tries to play there into Stuart Holden, and Chris Wondolowski is not missing that one, and it's taken a long time for him to get his first U.S. goal, and I know that he loves that that one went in so he can get the monkey off his back and start racking up the goals for the red, white, and blue.
I don't think Landon Donovan will get the assist there. It touched a Guatemalan last, didn't it? Because he's on 48 assists. That would have been number 49 in international soccer. And here's Wondolowski again. And it's official, though. Is no assist there for Landon Donovan. But congratulations to Chris Wondolowski. He's been magnificent in recent seasons for San Jose in Major League Soccer. 66 goals in his last 107 appearances since the start of 2010. The word prolific barely does him justice, but he just wanted that first goal for the United States, and now he's got it. Holden. Still Stuart Holden. Here it comes to Landon Donovan! Number 51 for Landon Donovan. And it's turning into a rout at Qualcomm Stadium. The United States lead Guatemala by 4-0. And he is all smiles.
Well, Stuart Holden and Mix Discaroot have advanced far forward and gotten into these spots, and that's a great ball in from Stuart Holden. Curls it in, Landon Donovan behind the defense by himself, but the loft on this pass to just put it on a platter for Landon Donovan. Landon's not going to miss that one from there, and right away he's given the credit to Stuart Holden for that great little combination, that outstanding pass, and that's going to be the last touch for Landon Donovan.
Well, he's placed the first marker down, Kyle, hasn't he? But he's back, he means business. An embrace between Jurgen Klinsmann and Landon Donovan. Will Bruin, by the way, is the man that's on the field from the Houston Dynamo in the sense of your screen, number 17. Landon told us yesterday that he and Jurgen Klinsmann haven't officially sat down and had a chat together since the camp started on Monday. Raimondo and Aguchi Onyewu just about dealing with that long ball forward. And here's Discaroot. He said it's going to be a long tournament. There's plenty of time to sit down. I think they're both waiting for the game. And that statement of intent by Landon Donovan is quite clear. And it might clear the air as well. Here's Minor Lopez. Jonathan Lopez. Three blue shirts in the penalty area. Offside, though, against Jonathan Lopez.
You know, it was a risky move from Jurgen Klinsmann to tell Landon Donovan he's got to earn his way back into this team, because if Landon Donovan came into this Gold Cup and didn't perform well, it's gonna would have been difficult for him to keep him involved afterwards. But if Landon Donovan plays well, the message that sends to the rest of the team that no one gets preferred treatment, everyone has to earn their opportunity. If Landon performs well and you get to have him join the World Cup and you get to show everyone else that I'm not giving anyone special treatment. That's a message that really could galvanize this team and get everyone fighting for spots moving forward.
Well, Jürgen challenged him to reach the maximum of his capabilities. He did say that he appears to be one of the gang again. After the squad gathered together on Monday in San Diego. And it's important to point out here, Carl, as well, Mitch Diskerud and Stuart Holden in the center of the park have changed everything, haven't they? Against a tiring Guatemala, it must be said. Here's Brett Shea, opportunities here for the United States. Will Bruin was sliding in, wide it goes, in his second international appearance, Will Bruin.
Well, look at how much space they're getting as well, and this is well done from Brett Shea. No need to try to beat the man there. You've got a little window to curl it in. Two runners in the box. Well done from Will Bruin to try to crash, but you're absolutely right. You know, Mitch Diskerud and Stuart Holden playing this half different than you saw Kyle Beckerman and Torres, where Beckerman was the one that sat a little more to allow Torres to go forward. You're seeing Mitch Diskerud and Stuart Holden a lot like Michael Bradley and Jermaine Jones, sharing the responsibility to get forward, to get back, and that double pivot's so difficult to defend against in the midfield, because both guys are capable of going forward and they've got the engines that they're honest enough to get back in the defensive side of things as well.
Guatemala made another substitution. Enrique Miranda, 22 years old, is in the game for Jonathan Lopez on the right-hand side, number 17. And his first cap against Nicaragua in January. Actually played against Argentina as well in that friendly defeat last month. Here he is for the first time, Miranda, to the feet of Contreras. Well, it took a while to get going this game. USA a little slow out of the box, trying to reacquaint themselves with each other, and then they picked up the pace. Landon Donovan with two goals, Hercules Gomez with one, and Chris Wondolowski with his first in international soccer. Diskerud has been everywhere in the second 45. Here's Shea. Getting each other's way that time. Miranda, flash of skill from him, and then a football tackle.
Yeah, the good part about a game like this, Arlo, is you learn a lot about your offensive players. It's tough to break down a team that's compact like this, but you don't learn a ton about your defensive guys.
Wondolowski to Holden. Stuart Holden on the right foot, slides it in. Will Bruin. One touch too many. Hasn't scored in his last seven in Major League Soccer for Houston.
Well, Stuart Holden definitely has that sharpness back, that explosion. He's found these little pockets. Great ball there. The first touch from Will Bruin, he wanted to take it inside and get it on that right foot. If he would have let it come across his body to the left foot, he gets that chance off. But Will Bruin has worked a lot on his game and running off the ball, and credits Brian Ching and some of the players at the Houston Dynamo that have helped him come a long way and not just be a poacher and a scrappy goal scorer, but to be a cerebral forward, thinking about ways to get open.
Milton Lille is on the field. Another substitution for Guatemala. Holden. Contreras, Castrillo, Miranda available on the touchline. Here he is on a bit of an island at the moment. Strength from Onyewu, wins the free kick against Wilber Perez.
Well, Onyewu and Goodson have been good tonight. You know, they've been organized, they've dealt well with a big, tall, strong forward. But the true test is going to come against teams like Costa Rica, against teams like Mexico when they get to the Gold Cup. They're playing very savvy forwards with midfielders that can deliver the ball to them.
And Wondolowski towards Will Bruin, putting some pressure on the Guatemalan defense. Goal kick. The makeup of the squad for the Gold Cup is interesting. 23 men are in it. 11 of them featured in the squad in the recent World Cup qualifiers. 10 are from Major League Soccer. 6 from Liga MX. The most ever in a US squad for a tournament. 5 of them started tonight. Seven of the players ply their trade in Europe. Josh Gatt is out of the squad injured. There are two uncapped players, Corey Ash and Jack McInerney. Neither of them dressed for tonight's game. And six of the players have three caps or less. The likes of Ash, McInerney, Tony Beltran, Will Bruins on the field, Bill Hamid, Sean Johnson, the two goalkeepers, Mix Discarude as well. There's Holden, who missed 36 internationals with those injuries. On Yewu. Bruin. Discarude again. Looking to pull the strings, prompting from the centre of the park. Lovely dummy by Beasley. Perplex Miranda, his Brett Shea. That's a heavy, heavy cross that sails behind. Two red and white striped jerseys to aim for in the penalty area. Wondolowski and Bruin. Brett Shea part of that team to win in the Azteca Stadium. Provided the assist for Orozco Fisgal's goal, the winning goal in that 1-0 win. And Jürgen Klinsmann in his reign is racking up a lot of firsts, Kyle, isn't he? A first win at the Azteca and in Mexico. That ended a run of 0-23-1 on Mexican soil over 75 years. Assistant referee flags for the free kick. It was a first win over the four-time World Cup winners, Italy. That was last February in Genoa. A goal from Clint Dempsey and a first qualifying victory in Jamaica. 2-1 last month with the Seattle Sounders' Brad Evans with that dramatic late-winning goal. The defending to do here inside the final 10 minutes for the US. John Marquez with this free kick. Towards the penalty spot. And the two players down on the ground, Lopez and Goodson, with another physical challenge and battle. Contreras. Working against Bedoya is Santiles. He's showing flashes tonight, Edward Santiles. Towards Lopez, well read off the bounce by Onyewu. Here's Brett Shea. It was interesting talking to Shea yesterday about that, what he described as a crazy day when he signed for Stoke City on the final day of the transfer window. He became a very famous man in England for 24 hours, Brett Shea, on a day that not too many big deals were done back in January. Said he had to go down to London on the train to have an interview for a work permit, then got back to Stoke and watched the whole thing unfold at the training ground when he waited for an answer. It was a positive yes, and there he is, playing the ball through to Bruin. He slides it across the six-yard area. Shea on the left foot, it's blocked. Shea on the right foot, dispossessed by Miranda. And offside against Minor Lopez. And then, of course, Kyle, what is traditional on transfer deadline day, when you're the big signing of the day, you have to endure the interview through the car window, don't you, with all the reporters and outside.
And it's hard as an American to be thinking, I'm on the wrong side of the car, figuring that out, this guy's interviewing me. They also had a laugh about the fact that it was he and Peter Odemwingie that were the guys that were getting interviewed, and he was laughing about Odemwingie's situation.
Trickery from Beasley on the right foot. Astria with the challenge. Here's Holden on the right foot himself. The drive comes in, it takes a deflection. And it's another corner for the United States.
Well, Jürgen Klinsmann off to my left, still urging the team on. And I think that's something important about this result, is you've seen the United States in games under Jürgen Klinsmann get up and play very well against teams and then drop off a little bit. And that's one thing that he wants, that he's seen more from the team lately, is just that 90-minute consistency to not let teams get back into games.
Guatemala will make their final two changes here to get some experience for some young players, but they'll defend the corner first, which is perhaps wise. Beasley. Deep service. Goodson is there with the volley. Oh, it's going to spin in, is it? No. And then it's roofed. into the back of the net. He earned the second opportunity there, Clarence Goodson, and he made no mistake with the second shot. A lethal strike, and it's 5-0 to the United States as we move into the last 6 minutes. A fourth international goal for Goodson.
Well, this is Goodson making me put my foot in my mouth about criticizing him at the top of the 18 in the first half with a lovely bit of skill to flick that up to himself, follow the play up, and then go high, knowing there's plenty of bodies on the line. Great little flick up to himself, gets the rebound, and just blasts that one, roofs it.
Well, you did mention earlier, Kyle, in fairness, that he was blasting them into the back of the net at training yesterday with the Gucci Onyewu. So it was on the cards, perhaps. Clarence Goodson, who will be playing out the rest of the season for the San Jose Earthquakes in Major League Soccer, of course, after 6 years in Scandinavia. Two more substitutions have been made by Guatemala. Angelo Padilla is in. Here comes Renato Sakin.
Making the fourth change, Guatemala substitution in the 85th minute.
So 5-0. It was only one at the breakthrough, Hercules Gomez. We've seen history tonight. Landon Donovan scoring his 50th from the penalty spot in international soccer, soon followed by his 51st. Chris Wondolowski scoring his first in international football.
And the United States will go into the Gold Cup in fine fettle, it seems.
That opening match in Portland at Geldwin Field, in front of a packed crowd, I'm sure, against Belize on Tuesday. Discaru with another teasing ball into the penalty area. He was looking to Will Bruin. Bruin is still there, gets the header in, arrested with the save. Fill your boots time, I think, for the United States tonight. Marquez plays it back to Vasquez. Closed down by Bruin. Closing stages from Qualcomm Stadium. Holden. Goodson. You have to go way back to June 2008 to the last time the United States beat an opponent by more than five. That was Barbados. Dempsey scored two that day. They put eight past the Bajans. Landon Donovan on the score sheet as well. Away goes Brett Shea. Is this number six? Shea across the goes. Here's an opportunity. That back post. The drive comes in. And it is number six. And it's Bedoya on the score sheet as well. They are thrilling the crowd here in San Diego tonight. Alejandro Bedoya on the score sheet. His first international goal. His 15th cap, and it's 6-0.
Oh, look at this ball, first-time ball from Stuart Holden. That's outstanding. Cut back, runners in the box, Bedoya following up. Sneaks that one in the near post, but that all starts with a terrific ball down the line from Stuart Holden. And calm, composed from Bedoya, just buries it. It's a rout now.
Precision from Bedoya with the side of the foot. Been in good form in Swedish soccer. And the chant of USA echoes around Qualcomm Stadium. 2 minutes left, they're in the move for a seventh. Discarud, Shea, Guatemala all over the place. Brett Shea! Wasn't far away from that top corner. And Jerez just looks shell-shocked, the goalkeeper. He's just climbed to his feet. Shaking his head. I think he wanted an offside call that time.
I think he wants a lot more than that.
I think he wants the full-time whistle call, yeah. Let's be honest.
But look at this. Shea just drives this one far post. Doesn't miss by much. But again, a good chance comes from a great ball from that center midfield position. Nick Discarud finding him, and Breck Shea's been a handful. The pace, the strength, and it's that final pass and the final shot, I think, that's going to bring him over the edge with Jurgen Klinsmann. assuage any fears that he has that maybe there's a lot of flash and there's a lot of potential, but the end product isn't there. He needs to show on a regular basis that it's going to be there, not only for Jurgen Klinsmann, but when he gets back with Stoke, and now that they're going to be a team that wants to build a new philosophy and not be that direct Group 1 hard-nosed team, a team that's going to put the ball on the ground and play. It might be his opportunity to show day in and day out that he can do that.
Here's Milton Leal, deep cross into the United States penalty area, claiming handball. The play on is the call. This is a late chance here for Guatemala to give themselves something to take home. Well, aside from the obvious and Landon Donovan scoring two goals, number 50 and 51, Kyle, could you make a strong case for Mix Diskerud advancing his cause the most tonight?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I think that's going to be the hardest decision for Jurgen Klinsmann to make, are the players that can play that center midfield spot. You know, he told us yesterday that it's Bradley and Jermaine Jones that have that spot at the moment, but anything can happen, whether it be injuries or a drop in form. And I think Mix Diskerud and Stuart Holden already making a huge claim that they deserve to be there. It's going to be about how they do in a Gold Cup, how they do when they go back to their clubs, and then it's all about those last qualifiers.
No stoppage time. The full-time whistle has been blown. 6-0 to the United States. They go into the Gold Cup in fine fettle. Chris Wondolowski with his first international goal. Landon Donovan with two tonight, the first US player to 50 in international soccer, and he added number 51 as well. He's back, there's no doubt about it. A super night for Landon Donovan. The San Diego American Outlaws have thoroughly enjoyed themselves. Another first tonight. Alejandro Bedoya rounded things off for goal number 6. Breck Shea had a couple of opportunities as well. Mix Diskerud and Stuart Holden terrific in the center of the park in the second half of the game. And it's onwards now to Portland next Tuesday for a matchup against Belize. Then it's Cuba in Salt Lake City and Costa Rica to round off the group phase of the Gold Cup. And on this form, the United States look like they could do some damage. They've reached the last three finals, all against Mexico. And Landon Donovan can reflect on a good night's work. Stay with us, plenty of reaction to come here from San Diego. The United States with a romp against Guatemala. They've won by 6-0.
A milestone night for Landon Donovan, who scored his 50th career international goal as the United States defeats Guatemala 6-0 in San Diego. And here's how it went down. It all started in the 42nd minute as Hercules Gomez put USA out.
Well, and that's just a great run from Joe Corona to bring in that right back and leave Hercules Gomez wide open far post. There's the little push on Landon Donovan. Goes down, referee points to the spot. How about this for 50? Just chip it down the middle. Come as you like, a huge moment for Landon Donovan. Another milestone reached.
And speaking of milestones, how about Chris Wondolowski? So prolific in Major League Soccer, finally gets his first
goal. And you know what? He's worked so hard for it. For it to come like that, an easy one right in front of the goal, you love it. He deserves it. And that's that monkey off his back now that he's going to be able to make it
through.
But Stuart Holden had a terrific half. Came on. Landon Donovan just sneaking in, and that outside back trying to hold the offside line. Center back doesn't read it. Wonderfully tucked in, and immediately Landon Donovan gives credit to Stuart Holden.
And immediately gets subbed out of the game.
And then it immediately comes and sits on the desk with us.
You know, that's pretty good. And we'll get to Landon in a second. He's hanging out. But how about Clarence Goodson's second chance?
I love it. And he just roofs it. He's got a lot of bodies on the line. Great little flick to get it to himself. Powers that one home. And just a rout at this point. And Bedoya.
Oh, Bedoya. Yeah.
Just calm. Nice. Goalkeeper comes out, sneaks it in near post.
Nothing like a 6-0 victory to get you all revved up for the Gold Cup is Landon Donovan. Joins us on the set, Russ Thaler, Kyle Martino, and Landon, congratulations on the win and goals number 50 and 51. Welcome back to the U.S. national team, Landon Donovan.
Thank you. Nice to be back. It was a great night, great crowd, great atmosphere, and it's nice to be ready and prepared for the Gold Cup. And for a lot of us, Wando got his first goal, Bedoya got his first goal, 50 for me. It was a really good night.
Now, playing against a team like this is going to prepare you for a couple of teams you'll play in Gold Cup. Right. But what are the things that need to be improved on? Obviously, this is a route, but you face a team like Mexico. You face a team like Costa Rica. What are the things that need to be brought to that next level to win games like that?
Well, in the end, it's 6-0, but the first 30 minutes were a little hectic. You know, they made it really hard on us. It took us a while to get our rhythm and get going. We knew that was going to happen when you have a lot of guys who don't play together often. That's going to happen. But eventually, we found our form. We got ourselves going. And in the end, it's nice to score goals, too.
Now, it's obviously good. We've talked about the challenge of having to reprove yourself to the national team. And it's never going to be one game that's going to bring you back. Wouldn't be one game that would keep you out of the picture. But it's got to feel good to start like this. What's your mindset as you prepare now for the Gold Cup?
Well, when things are bad, I try not to get too low. When things go well, you try not to get too high. Keep yourself even keel. I'm not doing a bunch of cartwheels because I scored against Guatemala in a 6-0 game. We got to do it when it matters, and I realize that. And we were good tonight, but we got to get better.
Landon, we noticed in the first half you started the game out wide, and you ended up moving up top, which is something that you do with L.A. How did that change come about? Did that come from the sideline, or did you decide that on your own?
We had those three in the middle, Joe, Jose, and Kyle, and we were sort of doing the same thing, and they were just packing the middle. We couldn't get a lot of the ball, so Jurgen and I spoke. We thought it made more sense to move up top with Herc and let Joe get some freedom in a better spot, and I think it worked out better for us.
Now, there's been some really good U.S. teams, and this could potentially be your fourth World Cup cycle, but you look at the experience of guys that are playing over in Europe and the MLS being a lot better. Do you think this is the most depth, the hardest it is to land a World Cup spot since your time back when you were 19 years old and you got your first chance?
Right. Well, you look at this team, and you could say this is a quote-unquote A-team, too. And a bunch of us weren't involved in the qualifiers. That team did very well. Now we have a group of 23 who performed very well tonight. It's important to have competition. It's important to push people. And with the way Major League Soccer has helped the national team, it's getting better and better. You have more and more depth. It's been great.
We know you love coming in and playing for the national team, and it shows. Last time we had Landon at a national team game, it was against Scotland.
Yeah, you had fun that game, too.
On the NBC Sports Network, get a hat trick.
Got to keep you guys around. Two more games.
It's pretty good. But now you go into the Gold Cup. Is this the kind of game you were hoping for? Is this what you were looking towards?
I think it's ideal in a lot of ways. One is we knew they were going to sit back and defend. I think when we play Belize, when we play Cuba, even Costa Rica to some extent, they're going to sit back and make it hard on us. So we have to break teams down. It's going to be difficult. And then to score a lot of goals is great for confidence.
Now talk about your buddy Bees. You guys have been through a lot together. And we had a great shot of after you scored the goal. I came over and congratulated you. Yeah. What's it like to see DeMarcus make his way back into this team after being out of the picture for a little while?
Well, it's funny how this game works and how life works. You know, Bees was sort of an afterthought for a long time and found his way back in. And when he had his 100th cap, I sent him a text and said, I couldn't be happier for you. And his reaction after my goal, I think, said the same thing. So it's nice to have a guy that you've known, grown up with for 15 years, and we get to share special moments together.
Landon, thank you so much. Congratulations, Landon Donovan.
Two goals, number 50 and number 51,
as USA defeats Guatemala 6-0 tonight in San Diego. Landon, thanks a lot. We'll be back from Qualcomm Stadium to wrap things up right after this. There's number two on the night for Landon Donovan. 6-0, your final. And we'll be right back.
Thanks.
Tomorrow night, Major League Soccer continues on the NBC Sports Network. Heated rivals collide in the Pacific Northwest when the Vancouver Whitecaps host the Seattle Sounders. It's tomorrow night, 11 p.m. Eastern on the NBC Sports Network. Claps all around as USA defeats Guatemala 6-0 here in San Diego. And for Arlo White and Kyle Martino, I'm Russ Taylor saying so long from Qualcomm Stadium. And once again, your final score, USA 6, Guatemala nothing.